I don't know about you, but if someone calls me without warning in 2024, I assume someone has died. I recently went on a date. Spoiler alert, it was a disaster. You ever been on a date where halfway through you're trying to figure out how to escape like you're in a spy movie? Let's talk about travel mishaps. I was traveling recently because I love paying $7 for airport water, of course. You ever notice the airport is like a parallel universe where everything costs more and yet you're more likely to spend it? It's like you get hypnotized. Yes, I will pay $14 for a soggy sandwich. And yes, I will eat it with a smile because I am not missing my flight for food. Time is ticking, and I can't let overpriced food hold me back from my journey. With my flight approaching, I make the bold decision to prioritize my travel over my meal. Nothing will stop me as I dash towards my gate, fueled by the thrill of adventure. I make it to the gate just in time, ready to embrace whatever comes next on my adventure. By the way, my mom just learned how to use emojis, and now she's unstoppable. She sends me a thumbs up for everything. Mom, I got a new job. Thumbs up. Mom, I'm sick. Thumbs up. I'm like, Mom, this is not an all-purpose emoji. You gotta have a range of emotions here. Throw in a sad face, maybe a balloon for good news. Something. Being in a relationship is just a series of questions, isn't it? What do you want to eat? I don't know. What do you want to eat? You ask that question enough times, you start reconsidering the whole thing. Like, why am I even with you if you don't have a strong opinion on tacos versus pizza? Life is weird, but if we can laugh at it together, maybe it's not so bad after all. So go out there, live your truth, even if your truth is pancakes. And if someone tries to call you, don't pick up.
One more you bitches ask to do my goddamn hair. Fuck no. Y'all fuck that. Saying stupid shit to a nigga talking about, no, nigga, your hair retain heat. Bitch, what the fuck? I done had this hair all day, bitch. It ain't burned me yet. The fuck is you talking about? Ain't nothing like Atlanta. I don't give a fuck what a nigga say. Nothing like Atlanta. It's so many. God damn. It's so many fine bitches in Atlanta make a nigga have a nervous breakdown. A shimmin' a night, y'all should have bought a Honda. Please don't get angry, lady. I'm only calling you bitches because I don't know your names individually. Holler if you hear me now. Let's not get sensitive this evening. Let's not. Life is too motherfucking short. I am happy than a motherfucker to be here. Ain't nothing like Atlanta. You don't know what the fuck you gonna get. This is the most nastiest, dirtiest, ugliest, most beautiful, wonderful place in all of America. You could get all your dreams could come true at Magic City, or you could get killed at a stoplight, nigga. You never fucking know. It can happen right here, nigga. You don't know what to tell Jesus. You just, Jesus, I don't know, damn. The nigga looked at me, I looked back, that was it, Jesus, I'm here now. Life is fucking short. Stop being ungrateful about your motherfucking life. You gotta learn to be grateful. If God done bless you with a Chrysler 300, be happy you got a Chrysler 300. Stop walking around talking shit, talking about, nigga, I got it because it looked just like a Phantom. No, nigga. It looked like a Chrysler 300. The fucked up part is it do look like a Phantom until a Phantom pull up. Then you just in that motherfucker. This is bullshit. I don't even want to be on this street, nigga. I don't even want...
Both of them talk too much. But at least the greedy rabbit is saying inspirational, motivational shit to the dick. She just, yes, 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 that's good. All right, that's good. All right, yes, 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 yes. The old one talk too much too. You can't understand shit she's saying. When you do, it's gonna scare the shit out of you. She just, rah, rah, and glory. Hot water cornbread. She's too old. She's a needy fish. Gotta pay attention to her. It ain't like a young one.
dog, pal.
What it is, Pimpin?
Going on, sir.
Ain't nothing to it but to do it, man. Sit back here blowing in the wind, at it again, once again, time and time again.
Yes, sir.
But I wanted to talk to you, man, before you do your thing this here evening, man. I understand you're doing something real big tonight, so before you do what you do, I want to give you some instructions.
All right.
Have that.
All right.
Now, the instructions is this, and I want you to pay close attention.
Yes, sir.
Before you step on stage tonight, you got to go up there with the spirit of the late, great Red Fox, the spirit of Richard Pryor.
Yes,
sir. The spirit of telling it like it is and not like it was. You dig? And only you can do what you do. That's why you're doing what you're doing. And you're doing it so flamboyant and so fly. And I'm watching from afar, but then again, I feel like I'm so near and I'm so close at the same time. And as I start to watch you and develop a keen sense of loving what you do and how you do what you're doing, Kat, stay hard in the yard. Don't play. Put some paint where it ain't. Don't be nervous. Be at their service. Give them what they want. Give them what they need, man. I want you to fly to the moon, young man. I'm gonna go up to the stars, and I want you to meet me there.
Yeah.
So I'll holler at you.
Y'all can't fuck the shit up because y'all own the shit. So y'all out there fucking it up and cleaning it up at the same time. White people just out there shaking their signs hard and shit. What are you doing? You using the shake weight? I'm riding, goddammit, I'm riding.
These are the truths they hiding from you. I risked my life to tell y'all these truths. I'm gonna tell you another one they'll have me crucified by the morning. Watch. All I gotta do is tell the truth. Watch this one. Wendy Williams is Bigfoot. There.
No murder in the fuck I see one.
No, what I'm talking about. My baby girl, 18 months. She was born with crack in her system. Now, when the baby born with crack in their system, their body don't develop right. So she was born at like 4 pounds or some crazy shit. So when the baby's born that small, then they put them on steroids so the body can catch up. I don't think these motherfuckers did the proper research that maybe crack and steroids ain't a real good combination for a baby girl. Got her walking around my house looking like 50 Cent in Pampers. She's...